all in today. Let's get ready. Let's worship God. Come on and share. We'll be back in a few moments, but let God be glorified. Come on, let God be glorified. All right, share. Let your friends and neighbors know. Life Builders Church is on the air. We're ready to worship and give God glory. Let's go. Yes, sir.
Come back every day, but
my God. Oh, the fire is burning already. Yes, sir. Come on, get your dance in. Come on, let's enter his gates with thanksgiving. Enter his courts with praise. Hallelujah. Oh, come on, praise him. Yes, sir. Yeah. That's how we should do it back in the day. Come on, somebody praise him. Come on, share with your neighbor. Share with your brother and sister. Let's get ready to praise him. Come on. Yes, sir. Glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. My God, beloved, why don't you come share with us? Let God be glorified. Let God be worshipped. Let God be praised. Let God be lifted up. Hallelujah. What you need today, God's got it. God's got it. God's got it. God's got it. I said God's got it. Hallelujah. Glory. Yes, he has. He's got your needs met. He's got healing for your body. He's got saving for your soul. He's got righteousness. He's got peace. He's got power. He's got authority. Everything you need. Everything you need. Everything you need. Hallelujah. God's got everything you need. Good morning and a happy Father's Day. Happy Father's Day. First of all, to all my family, my brothers, my son, my God beloved, my nephews. Thank God for those great men of God that are part of our lives. Thank God for even the memory of my own dad. We praise God for just how good he is, how faithful he is. All the men of Light Builders Church, all the men of Full Gospel Christian Fellowship, all the fathers of AIM, all my man of God, Apostle Ira Hilliard, my God, thank God for him. Thank God for every man that's listening today. That's a father. We love you. We celebrate you. And we appreciate you. For this is the day that the Lord has made. We do rejoice and we're glad in it. Welcome to Father's Day. Sunday, my God, June 21st already. June 21st, 2020. This is the sixth month, the 21st day. Half the year is over. But we still praise God. And I want everybody who has had something you're trusting God for, standing in faith for, believing God to do, don't drop it. Because God is not short concerning his word. Let's pray. Father, thank you for the privilege of worship today. Thank you for you said to enter your gates with thanksgiving and to enter your courts with praise. You said to be thankful unto you and bless your name. For you are good, your mercy is everlasting, and your truth endures throughout all generations. Father, we're ready to worship. So get in the midst. Your word says you inhabit the praises of your people. You whirl and twirl and bless the praises of your people as you inhabit. So Lord, we thank you for your word, for your promise, and for your presence. Lord, you arise and every enemy be scattered and do us good today. And we will not touch your glory. We will not hinder your praise. But God, you get the glory today. And we thank you in Jesus' name. Pastor Al is coming now to lead us in worship. My God, I don't want you to just sit. I want you to participate. I want you to honor God. Come on, baby, in your worship and let God be glorified. You all ready for worship? I don't hear nobody. Y'all ready for worship? I still don't hear nobody. I don't see no hearts. I don't see no stars. I don't see no yes I am. So I just want you to start. My God, and let's worship God. Come on, baby. It's time to give him praise.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Looking good this morning in orange.
God bless you.
Hallelujah.
Thank you. Happy Father's Day. Happy Father's Day to my love, to my husband, to my everything, my all-time boyfriend. Everlasting boyfriend. Thank God. And happy Father's Day to all of you that are watching. Father figures, uncles, grandfathers, grandfather, grand father, uncle. Happy Father's Day. God bless you. Thank God for making you who you are and how you are there and how you always pour into others. May your sons, your grandsons call up, Rods can call you blessed. Amen. Give God the glory. Lord, you're mighty.
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 Whoa. Lord, you're mighty.
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 Oh Lord, I worship you.
Lord, you're mighty.
I give you glory.
Lord, you're mighty.
I give you
praise. Lord, you're mighty.
And adoration.
Lord,
come on and worship. We lift you up right now. We give you all the glory. We give you all the praise. Oh Lord, how excellent is your name in all the earth. You set your glory above the heavens and of all the rain, sun, moon, and the stars. Well, no praise is high enough to express how great you are. Oh, what a mighty God.
Yes, He is a mighty God. Oh, God, I give you praise this morning. I give you the adoration. Come on and worship with me.
Angels, they bow before the mighty God. Yeah. What a mighty God He serves. What a mighty God He serves. Angels bow before the mind of God. Hallelujah, oh yeah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. All glory, all honor, all praise, all praise to the mighty God. He deserves the glory. He deserves the honor. He deserves the praise. There is none like God. And we need to understand today, in the times we're living in, that no matter what, God deserves the glory. And guess what? When we give him the glory, we put him first, and we seek him for the answers, we seek him for what we need, he will answer. And he always answers. And because he always answers, he's always there. Unlike, you know, our homie, our best friend, who we can't always count on. We can't always say that the person we love and the person that we depend on all the time through the years is always there. It's just impossible. It's impossible to put that kind of pressure on someone to be your everything and all in all. But Jesus is, and he deserved the glory. Guess what? He will always be there. He will always be there. Even when we think he's not there, there are times when we think, God, I don't hear you. God, what are you doing in my life? What's going on? Where are you? I don't hear you. But God is always, he's always there. He is always there, and he's listening. And sometimes he's just maybe waiting for us to come to him and just to tell him, you know what, Lord, you deserve it. You deserve the glory. And I'm going to give you all that I have. I'm going to give you my life. I'm going to dedicate my life to you. I want to give you my praise, oh God. I'm going to give you all that's within me. I'm going to give you that thing that I may have been keeping. Sometimes we keep ourselves from God. We resist. We draw back when we don't think God has given us enough, or he's not answering soon enough. We draw back, don't we? We draw back and we think, well, you know what? I can't give him. But God wants us to, today, he wants us to come boldly before the throne of grace. He wants you
subscribe
to
in the
just
app
give
for
him.
Multi-chapter.
He wants you to give him the best. He wants you to give him your best. Don't hold back. Give him the precious things. The precious things of your heart, of your life. Give it to him. Give it to him. Come on and give it to him. We worship you today, oh God, we give you the glory. We give you honor, all praise. Oh, yeah. My hallelujah belongs to you, yes. My hallelujah belongs to you, Lord. My hallelujah belongs to you. My hallelujah belongs to you. You deserve it. You deserve it.
You deserve it. You bless your name today. Lord, I bless your name today. Oh, come on and sing with me. Say hallelujah. Hallelujah. Sing hallelujah. Oh, praise to God. Hallelujah. Lord, we give you glory and all the honor and all the praise. Yeah, you deserve it. Jesus. Lord, I bless your name today. Lord, Lord, I worship you right now, Lord. Nobody but you gets the glory. Nobody but you gets the honor. Yeah, Lord, I love you with all my heart, my soul, my mind, my strength. Every part of me, Lord, loves you, worships you, and worship you. Yeah. Oh, come on and sing, sing hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, sing hallelujah. All the glory and all the honor and all the praise, yeah, you deserve it. Nobody but you deserve the glory. Nobody but you gets the honor, yeah. Nobody but you gets the glory. Lord, I worship you. Right now, I give you glory. God, I give you praise right now. You're the love of my heart, you're my soul, my strength, you're my heart, yeah. You deserve it. You deserve it. You deserve it. My hallelujah belongs.
Subscribe in the mobile app for mobile chat worship music for your ministry today.
My hallelujah belongs to you. Oh, my hallelujah belongs to you. My hallelujah. My hallelujah. Oh, my hallelujah. Belongs to you. Oh, 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 oh. Lord, I worship you, I worship you, Jesus. Lord, I bless your name, I bless your name. My hallelujah belongs to you. My hallelujah belongs to you. My hallelujah belongs to you. Lord, my hallelujah belongs to you. For you deserve it.
Say it, baby.
You deserve it.
Say it again.
You deserve it.
Yes, you do, Lord.
You deserve it.
All the glory.
All of the glory belongs to you.
Can somebody help us say it? All the glory.
All the glory. And all the honor
to you.
Humbly.
Come on, help me say everybody. All of the glory belongs to you. Come on, saints, say it again. All of the glory belongs to you. Come on, lift your hands and worship God. Come on, give him glory. Give him glory. Give him honor. Give him praise. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. He alone is God. He alone is faithful. He alone is awesome. He alone is mighty to save. He alone is everlasting. He alone is true and worthy. Worthy, worthy of the glory. Worthy of the honor. Worthy of the praise. Worthy of the thanks. Worthy of God and the title, not just the title, but who he is, what he's done, how good he's been. Faithful God. Can somebody help me declare? Faithful God. Faithful God. Faithful in the midst of every situation. faithful in the midst of every circumstance. Faithful today, faithful tomorrow, faithful the day after. Faithful, faithful, faithful God. And we bless him. We honor him. We adore him. He alone is good and worthy of praise, worthy of glory, and worthy of honor. This day is the day that the Lord has made. We do rejoice and we're glad in it. We're grateful for it. Everybody, you ready for the word? Father, anoint us now to hear. Lord, I'm already anointed to declare. Nothing will hinder the word from coming forward or being received. Nothing in this body, nothing in this atmosphere, nothing among the people, nothing in the airwaves. Father God, you arise and every enemy be scattered. And Lord, hide this your servant beyond the cross, and all of you be seen and heard and not me. I promise you, I will not touch your glory, nor will I hinder your praise. But signs and wonders shall accompany and follow your word. So we utter it, and it shall be in Jesus' name. Hold up your Bibles, everybody, and let's declare, Lord, I thank you that I have a Bible. It is my personal copy, a basic instruction before leaving earth. I am a believer, not a doubter. I'm not just a hearer, but I'm also a doer. And my life is so much better because of the word of the living God. Therefore, I declare, my mind is alert. My heart is receptive. I will not be distracted, but I will hear what thus saith the Lord. And as a result of what I hear today, somebody help me say it loud and proud. I'm going to leave this experience better than I came here in Jesus' name. Amen, amen, amen. It's not too late to share with somebody because the word is about to be declared. And beloved, I want to hear God hear our praises and our lips saying thank you. My God, you see I got on my lab coat. We're back in the examination room because we're still dealing with the issue of heart sickness. Heart sickness. Beloved, my task today is to identify the symptoms and push us to the cure. Heart sickness. So let's continue talking about healing heart sickness. You can't heal what you don't identify. You can't heal what you don't acknowledge. So, beloved, I don't want to undervalue what's going on in our world, the pandemic. I'm not saying it's not important, but I do want to say that heart sickness is impacting more people. Heart sickness is destroying hopes, dreams, and lives. Heart sickness is tearing down vision, discouraging hearts, and moving people away from their God-ordained assignment. We want to get rid of heart sickness in the name of Jesus. So it is devastating beyond what we could ever imagine. Even if we are well physically, heart sickness can destroy you from inside out. And we want to be in a posture to attack and eradicate heart sickness. So again, beloved, we're talking about heart sickness. Where did it come from? Because we are again identifying the symptoms, and this is part two. Not only where did it come from, how is it spreading so fast to so many? I mean, it is. You talk to people today, you hear it in their voice. You see it in their eyes. You hear it in their expression. Many people have no drive for life, caught up on other people's dreams and finding out they don't have any either. Following behind people that are angry without reason, angry without cause, in trouble with things, and they don't know how they got in trouble. Heart sickness. Oh, why is it killing so many? Is there a treatment for it? And is there a cure? Well, again, let's go to our word in Proverbs chapter 13, verse 12 through 15. Proverbs chapter 13. verse 12 through 15, reading from the King James, it says, "Hope deferred maketh the heart sick, but when the desire comes, it is a tree of life. Whoso despiseth the word shall be destroyed, but he that feareth the commandment shall be rewarded. The law of the wise is a fountain of life. To depart from the snares of death, hear me, good understanding giveth favor, but the way of transgressors is hard." The way of transgressors is hard. Oh, my. Hope deferred makes the heart sick. Hope deferred is described this way: desiring something, working diligently towards a goal, and it becomes seemingly unattainable. Unexplained delays in gratification and fulfillment. That's hope deferred. Now, what many hope for has been deferred for diverse reasons. In our present day, beloved, we have challenges that seem to be unprecedented. And for one reason or another, some have lost their hope. Some have lost family. Some have lost jobs. Some have had income decline. Some don't know why, but they feel hopeless, helpless. Hope has been lost. But the unfortunate thing is that many are filling that void with the wrong things. Things like anger and strife. Things like hatred and division. Things like suspicion and mistrust. Oh my God. We know it's heart sickness because the symptoms prevail. We know it's heart sickness because, beloved, many people are hopeless today and their hearts are not giving any indication of drive or desire for better. But the good news I declare right now, come on, let's go. My God, heart sickness is both treatable and curable. Can somebody give God praise right on that? Heart sickness is both treatable and curable. God have mercy. Let's get into this. My God, I want to continue to deal with the symptoms so that we can undertake the regimen one symptom at a time. I want to continue to deal with the symptoms so that we can knock out the disease one step at a time. All right? So there is symptom number one we talked about last time. Symptom number one of heart sickness. My God, compromised speaking. You're not talking right. Out of your mouth is gloom, doom, despair. No drive, no, nothing good to say. Negativity, using the words that we say today. Negativity out your mouth everywhere, every time you talk, around everybody you talk to, everything is negative. Negative, 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 negative. Nothing positive. Nothing good to say. Oh my God, heart sickness prevails. Now, here's symptom number two we're going to deal with today. Unbridled fear. Unbridled fear. Unbridled fear. What is unbridled fear? Well, fear is a human emotion that is able to be controlled under normal conditions. So I don't want you to think something wrong with you because you have fear or are afraid. You know, I bring it up to young men. They're now grown men. But I can be honest with you. My wife and I didn't get any sleep from the time they were born even to the time they left to go off to college and move out on their own. One is married. One is working and outside of the state. And, you know, I still have a habit. I keep my cell phone on just in case they call. It's not a fear like I have no hope, but I'm concerned for my children. I'm a pastor. I'm concerned for the congregation. So it's not a fear like I'm trembling, but I always want to be ready to be available. So there's a lot of things out here that causes people to be afraid. Can I get a witness here? Fear is a human emotion, but we have control over fear. But for some reason, so many today have unbridled fear. Fear that seems to not be controlled. Afraid of everything. Afraid of a cough. Afraid of a sneeze. Afraid of somebody too close. Afraid of somebody not calling. Afraid of not being able to get somebody after three rings. Afraid that something bad has happened. Afraid, my God, that when the bosses go in the room, close the door and have a talk, that they're going to come out handing out pink slips. Now I realize some of this has happened, but are we to fear unbridled? I'm talking today, I believe, primarily to people of faith, people that love the Lord, people that have a relationship with God, that say they trust Him, that say they love Him, and yet we are the ones that seem to be suffering most from unbridled fear. Many are giving in to fear. Let me take my time with this. Maybe it's the pressure of our times. I don't know. I mean, maybe it's the lethal aspect of the present pandemic. I mean, fear can grip anybody instantaneously. But the fear that we're seeing manifested in our present times seems to come from a long pondered place. It seems to come from a place that has been festering for years. Fear, unbridled, undealt with. It seems this kind of fear has been long contemplated, stewing in our spirit, stewing in our heart long term. But let me give you the remedy, the regimen, and the redeeming quality of the curing power of God. First of all, here are a few biblical facts about fear. Number one, according to 2 Timothy 1:7. You don't have to turn there, but know it's a fact because it's God's word. God did not give us the spirit or the life of fear. That's a biblical fact. God didn't give us fear. No. I would like to think that when Adam and Eve fell and messed up in the Garden of Eden, one of the outflows of their disobedience was fear. Lack of knowledge or lack of being able to discern security, safety. But God didn't give that to us. Oh no. Let's finish it out. What did He give us? He gave us power, love, and a sound mind. That's 2 Timothy 1:7. Another biblical fact. Perfect love casts out fear. Perfect love casts out fear. According to 1 John 4:18. Perfect love throws fear out the door. Throws fear out the window. Oh my God. And also according to 1 John 4:18, we understand that torment accompanies fear. So whenever you have fear, torment is coming with it. Torment. Oh my God. What's going to happen? Oh my God. What done happened now? Oh my God. What in the world am I going to do? My security has been compromised. But here's one fact that I want you to get ready to rejoice over. You ready? Hold on to your seat. The term, two words, fear not, is mentioned some 365 times in the Bible. Fear not, for every day of a given year, God said, fear not. 365 times from Genesis to Revelation is the phrase, fear not mentioned. Man, that's a good place to praise God right there. So I want you to understand that fear is not from God. Unbridled fear is not something God gives us, but it is a symptom of heart sickness. Number one, because God didn't give it to you, where did it come from? How do you develop unbridled fear if God didn't give it to you? Come on. And number two, fear is a major hindrance of faith. Fear hinders faith from manifesting. And I want y'all to get this. And I'm going to say it more than once. What you plant in faith, fear can uproot. I'm going to say it again. What you plant in faith, fear acts to uproot. I believe God to heal me. You feel a lump, bump, or bruise. Then you start reading up of what the lump mean, what the bump mean, what the bruise mean. You have a cough. You start reading up on what kind of cough it is. Now, some may say, I'm trying to get facts. I hear you. But what did God say? I heal all of your diseases. I crown your head with life. Fact in Psalm 103, 3 and 4. By his stripes we are healed. Isaiah said that same when God spoke. So the fact is God's word. The fear comes to uproot what God has said. Because where your focus goes, your power flows. And if you focus on fear, it don't matter how much you name it, claim it, blab it, grab it, confess it, declare it. If you allow fear to be unbridled in your life, it will root up everything you've sown in faith. Oh, I'm a tither. Oh, I gave my gift to God of sowing, offering, and seed. But I still feel broke, busted, and disgusted. I still feel like I'm not, let me calm down. I still feel like I'm not going to make it. I still feel like, my God, my retirement going to run out. I still feel like there's going to be more month than money. Oh, God. What you plant in faith, fear acts to uproot. The key is you cannot allow fear to uproot your faith. You cannot allow fear to uproot your faith. I'm going to say it till y'all get it. You cannot allow fear. Come on, somebody tweet that. Write that. Possess it as something you know to be true. I cannot allow fear to uproot my faith. My faith is in what God said. My faith is in what I heard God say, what I believe God said, how I obey what God said, and then how I make adjustment to what I say, to how I act, to how I think, to line up with the God said. Can somebody say, I must line up with the God said, so that fear won't act to uproot my faith. I must stay in agreement with what God said so that fear, even though it may be things on the right hand, things on the left hand, staring me in the face, biting at my heels, it must be that I believe what God said. Can I give you a scenario before I close? Because, beloved, fear is all around us. Fear is all around us. Things happen every day. So here's a scenario before we close, and we're going to praise God. Look with me at Luke's Gospel, chapter 8, verse 41 and 42. Then we're going to skip down to verse 49 through 55. And then we're going to praise God. Luke chapter 8, verse 41 and 42. Then skip down to verse 49 and 55. And behold, the Bible says in Luke 8, 41, there came a man named Jairus, and he was a ruler of the synagogue. And he fell down at Jesus' feet and besought him that he would come into his house. For he had only one daughter, almost about 12 years of age, and she lay a dying. But as he went, the people thronged him. Here's where the story of the woman with the issue of blood comes into place. But skip down now to verse 49 to 55, because we'll save the woman with the issue of blood for another time. While he yet spake, there cometh one from the ruler of the synagogue's house, because Jairus was an important man, saying to him, "Thy daughter is dead." Verse 49. "Thy daughter is dead. Trouble not the master." Oh, but what Jesus heard it. He answered Jairus, saying, "Fear not." There's one of those fear nots. "Believe only, and she shall be made whole." Lord, have mercy. And when he came into the house, he suffered no man to go in, save Peter and James and John, and the father and the mother of the maiden. Sometimes when you're in faith, you got to limit your circle. You got to shrink your entourage, because everybody's not in faith with you. Lord, have mercy. He shrunk his circle down to Peter and James and John and the father and mother of the maiden. And all wept. I mean, tradition says that they even hired mourners. Professional criers came in. Oh, God. And bewailed her, because she was 12 years old. It's horrible when a child dies like that. But Jesus said, look at here, "Weep not, she's not dead, but sleepeth." Oh, what? I mean, they transferred from bitter weeping, and we see in the same text, now they were laughing him to scorn. Are you crazy? I felt the pulse. I put the mirror over her nose. I listened to her chest, heart not beating, mirror not fogging up, no pulse. Oh, you said she's asleep. Oh, he's crazy. Oh, God. And he put them all out. That's what Jesus did. Put them all out and took her by the hand and called, saying, "Maid, arise." And her spirit came again, and she arose straightway, and he commanded to give her meat. Something I got to say about this text before we go on. Jesus did not agree with the narrative that she was dead. He did not accept what they were saying, because he knew what he was going to do. When you have unbridled fear will uproot what you know God's going to do. It's not that God fails. It's that you let fear mean more to you than what God said. Jesus did not allow the weeping, the wailing, the professional mourners, the crying, the acting up, even the laughter at him when he declared what he was going to do. I've got to cause you to understand, when you stand in faith, everybody gonna have something to say. I remember years ago when I was believing God for something, and somebody actually said out of their mouth, and I'm not bitter, I just remember, "Don't help him, he's standing in faith. Don't come to his aid, he's standing in faith." God moved. He may not have used that person, but God showed up. Jesus wants us to realize what he said he will do. What he promised, he will perform. Oh my God, I got to get ready to close. But beloved, he said, "My God, give her something to eat." My God. He came in, said she wasn't asleep. When they said he crazy, he put him out. Told the young lady to arise and said, "Give her something to eat." Oh my God. Oh God. Jairus came to Jesus Oh, I feel this now. Being a ruler of the synagogue, he had status, but the threat came in his house and right in his face. He only had one daughter, but he was threatened, my God. And he asked Jesus to accompany him home to see about his daughter. But on the way, two things happened. Well, the first thing that happened is that somebody else needed Jesus. That's what I was talking about, the woman at the issue of blood. My God, isn't it something that sometimes you need Jesus and you feel like you got his attention, and then somebody else comes along with a need? But can I speak to that? He is not deaf to your cries. He is not ignoring your situation. No matter how many people are calling on him, he hears your cry. He'll answer your inquiry. He'll look after your situation. Can I get a witness? Beloved, I'm here to let you know that even while Jesus was following Jairus, the woman with the issue of blood simply touched the border of his tallit, touched the hem of his garment, and her issue of blood dried up. So I'm here to tell you, don't get upset that if you and Jesus are going on towards answering your inquiry, don't feel like somebody has interrupted you. My God, oh, I remember the old song that the saints used to sing. Pass me not, O gentle Savior, hear my humble cry. While on others thou art calling, do not pass me by. Somebody could say that was referring to blind Bartimaeus. Somebody else could say that was referring to the woman with the issue of blood. I say it refers to all of us. Savior, Savior, hear my humble cry. I'm not selfish, but while on others thou art calling, do not pass me by. How many can believe God right now that, Lord, you're God enough to answer everybody else and answer me too? You're God enough to hear my brother's prayer and hear mine too. You're God enough to deliver somebody else and deliver me too. Can somebody say, yes, Lord? Hallelujah. Oh my God, calm down, boy. But here's what happened, number two. Look at what the Lord did. On the way to the house, somebody gave the unwelcome news to Jairus that his daughter had died. But I want you to go back to Luke's gospel, chapter 8 and verse 50, and look how Jesus confronted bad news. But when Jesus heard it, he answered him saying, fear not, believe only, and she shall be made whole. Who am I preaching to who's in the midst of a threatening situation? Who am I talking to in the midst of something that's going on in your life and you feel like, I'm not going to get out of this? But I'm coming to tell you that Jesus had arrived to the house and he was confronted with weeping and wailing, but he did not respond to that. Oh, Lord. Oh, I feel the preacher coming now. Oh, they laughed at him and laughed at what he said. And they said that Jairus' daughter was dead, but he did not respond to that. He said, she's only sleeping. Oh, God. Hallelujah. And they continue to laugh at him. But look at something else. Jesus took matters out of the hand of unbridled fear. He took matters out of the hand of the circumstances that were staring him in the face. Can I get somebody to agree with me? I'm not going to let the devil get the credit. I'm not going to let the devil take the glory. I'm not going to let the devil or adverse circumstances take my praise, take my faith, take my belief, take my hope. I understand what I see, but I heard what God said. Oh, my God in heaven. So here we are right now. Somebody's confronted today, just like Jesus was confronted with a dead little girl. But he knew what God said he would do. Nobody said that fear would not assault you. Nobody said that fear would not come knocking on your door. Nobody said that you would not have circumstances that stare you in the face, that breathe down your back, that blow its hot breath right down into your face. But I want you to understand that fear must be bridled. Fear must be arrested. Fear must be cast down. Can you help me declare? I must bridle my fears. I must cast down my fears. I must arrest my fears. God have mercy. Fear will run you crazy. It'll make you lose your mind. And it will definitely uproot your faith. But fear cannot be allowed to rule. Fear, my God, cannot be allowed to dictate your response. I know you're human. I'm human too. But beloved, there's something I always say, and I want to bring it back because I haven't said it in a while. PFP. PFP. Pause for peace. Pause for peace. Pause for peace. When you're confronted with something that you were not expecting, pause for peace. When you're confronted with a situation that seems going to take you out, pause for peace. When you feel like you're about to be overwhelmed, pause for peace. I heard Jesus say, my peace I leave with you. My peace I give unto you. Not as the world gives. Let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid. I dare somebody text that. I dare somebody hashtag that. PFP, pause for peace. I'm not going to give up what I've been fighting for. I'm not going to give up what I've been praying for. I'm not going to give up what I've been believing for. I heard the Lord say, be careful for nothing, through the Apostle Paul, but in everything, my God, with prayer and supplication, make your requests known unto God, and the peace that passes all understanding shall keep your hearts, shall keep your minds stayed on Christ Jesus. I dare somebody throw it up and say, pause for peace. When the wicked come against me, pause for peace. When the enemy tries to take me out, pause for peace. When the enemy tries to rule in my home, pause for peace. There is a solution. There is a God who hears and answers prayer. Lord, I will not let unbridled fear ruin my life. Oh my God, I feel this. Oh God, fear must not rule. Fear cannot believe or cannot be allowed to dictate your process and response. Fear must not remain unchecked. As I close, who are you? Who are you? Are you a child of God or not? Are you a child of God or not? I know we feel hurt. Just before coming on the air today, received some horrible news about a longtime dear friend. But who am I? I'm a child of God. I'm bought with a price. And she's with the Lord. She's with the Lord. She's with the Lord. I have peace. And I'm not going to let unbridled fear destroy me. Is your fear, if it's allowed to remain, it will make your heart sick. If your fear is allowed to stay where it is, it will ruin everything you've been praying about, fasting for, believing God for. You got to arrest your fear. It must not be unchecked. You can die from heart sickness. Your visions, your dreams can die from heart sickness. You can spread it in your home, in your family. It must not go unchecked. I gotta close. But the words of the psalmist calling me out right now. Man, I feel like dancing. Lord God, help me. Oh, somebody come get me. Lord, I feel this. Psalm 27, verse 1. Lord, help. Lord, it says the Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? Lord, have mercy. The Lord is the strength of my life. Who shall I be afraid? You don't like this, huh? I'm preaching to somebody now. You need to skip down to verse 13 and 14. I had fainted unless I had believed to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. He is my remedy for today. Wait on the Lord. Be of good courage, and he shall strengthen thine heart. Wait, I say, on the Lord. You can take two of these and call the Lord in the morning. Because wait means, in the Hebrew, to bind yourself to. Bind yourself to. Come on, bind yourself to God. They that wait, they that bind themselves, tie themselves to God, shall renew or exchange their strength. They shall mount up with wings like an eagle. They'll run and not get weary, walk and not faint. Wait on the Lord. But you can also say, wait, W-E-I-G-H-T. I'm going to cast my cares on the Lord. W-E-I-G-H-T. For he cares for me. I'm going to roll that weight on the Lord. So this is the remedy. This is the remedy for unbridled fear. Wait on the Lord. Wait on the Lord. W-A-I-T and W-E-I-G-H-T. Wait on the Lord. Remedy your fears and trust God to do what he said he would do. Why? Who is it? Of my life. Oh God. We gotta put fear on the run. We gotta put fear in this place. Oh God. I know this is an old song, but it's still so appropriate. Oh, he shall hide me. Come on, say, oh, in. God have mercy. He shall hide me. God have mercy. Come on, somebody say, in the time. He shall hide me. Hallelujah. He shall strengthen my heart. Hallelujah. Who shall I fear? Who shall I fear? Father God, in the name of Jesus, I've done what you told me to do. I prayed for somebody even before this message that they would not fear. They would not be trapped in the abyss of fear. They will not be caught up in what other brothers say and other sisters say, but they will trust you and believe your word. So Father, right now as I pray, somebody's in fear because their soul's not right. I'm talking to you now. You're not right with God. You have not given Jesus your heart. Yeah, you got a lot to fear because eternity is a long time to be separated from God. I want to tell you right now, you can give your heart to Jesus. If you are here today and hear me talking to you, write us at lbcministry@yahoo.com. Somebody standing by to return your message and minister. Also, you can call us at 443-776-0255. The Bible said with the heart, man believeth unto righteousness, and with the mouth, confession is made unto salvation. Somebody today can give your heart to Jesus, and I'm praying that you do in Jesus' name. I'm praying for those that are in fear. Our prayer counselors are standing by. If you're in fear and it's been making your heart sick, we can pray together, get you right, because our God hears and answers prayer. He hears and answers prayer. He hears and answers prayer. Again, 443-776-0255. I'm dropping the net for salvation. Dropping the net for prayer. If you don't have a church home, you can be an online partner of Light Builders Church. Make your intention to the prayer counselor. Make your intention to dialing 443-776-0255 or write us by email lbcministry@yahoo.com. I want you to resist fear because God is here for you. He's here for you. Lord, have mercy. Lord, I give you praise for those that are responding to the word. Thank you, Lord, for all you've done, for all you're about to do. And I praise you for it, Father. Oh, yes, I do. Hallelujah. Man, I feel the Holy Ghost. Oh, my God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Who shall I fear? Lord, have mercy. Okay. Get yourself together, boy. I feel the Holy Ghost. Lord, have mercy. Somebody's responding to God right now. And I bind that spirit of fear. I declare it ceases and desists right now. In Jesus' name. Well, we are a church that believes in tithe and offering. We believe in giving into the work of the ministry. We believe that when you give into God's house, you're honoring Him. Not only obeying Him, but you're trusting Him. We want to give you an opportunity to give right now. You can go to PayPal, our trusted source, and put in your our email address, lbcministry@yahoo.com. Put in that email address and seed as God gives you a heart to. Also, a mailing address is going to come on your screen. If you desire to mail in your seed, follow the instructions on your screen and mail your seed in to Light Builders Church. Care of Light Builders Church. Beloved, I love you. Appreciate you. Man, I feel like running. I don't have that much room. But baby, would you mind if I leaped over the sofa? Oh, God, we still in our living room. We're exercising wisdom. We'll be opening soon. We'll let you know But until then, stay with us online. Here today, let's deal with this heart sickness. Hallelujah. Now they taking this back old school. They going to back to church. Some of my young listeners might be, all right, Bishop, give me something a little more updated. Well, let's try this out. Let's try this out. I wonder if you want a little bit updated as we get out of here. I want to know if you're ready for something a little updated. Something that God's going to do to bless your life. Father, we can ready to let you go. So y'all be blessed. And let Bishop William Murphy III take us out. Because the Lord is my light and my salvation. That all right with you? A little bit more updated. God bless you. This is my brother here. I love him. Sing, sir. God bless you. Happy Father's Day. Dear Father, Father, bless your people with a tremendous day. Those that are grieving that Dad's not here, give us an extra portion of strength today. Let your blessing rest upon us. We give you praise. We give you glory and honor. For you alone are the good Father, the excellent Father. We praise you. We say together that God dwells in the midst of Life Builders Church. God dwells in the midst of a blessed community. Beloved, grace and peace be unto you. Peace be unto you, and peace be multiplied. Stay with us a while, and let this song minister. The Lord is my life, my salvation. Who shall I fear? God bless you. God bless you.
We said our hope on you. We said our hope on you. Richard James Morton.